Uncle C, back in the office, and in today's video, we're gonna be discussing the 10 more tests that women will constantly throw your way when you're dating. And the reason why I'm making this is because if you saw my video from a couple days ago, here's a picture of the thumbnail, here's the card at the top of the screen, you're going to see that this video has absolutely erupted. And it's because when men actually see an inside look at what happens inside the mindset of female nature, not only can they spot tests far easier, but what happens is they can date and actually attract the quality or type of companion that they've always wanted. Because of that, today we're discussing the 5 more tests. And the way that I'm going to be breaking this down is through front end game. And these are the 5 tests you're going to notice in the front end when you first meet the woman. Front end game is your seduction in the beginning of the interaction. On this side of the whiteboard, after, we're going to be discussing back end game and the 5 extra tests that you're going to notice when you see a woman on a long-term basis or have a long-term companion. Let's dive in. Now, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Casey Zander. I'm the founder of Headman. I'm here to revitalize masculinity and help make men full stack. And before we begin, fellas, real quick, a few spots this month have opened for the one-to-one mentorship with myself. I have a full description down below. You should 100% check that out, so that way I can actually aid you and further your development this month on a one-to-one basis. But nevertheless, let's dive in. What are the 5 tests that you're going to notice on the front end? Well, the very first is going to be the insecurity test, okay? What the insecurity test is this is especially going to happen within the first day to the first month, okay? You're only going to typically notice this test when you first start seeing a woman and when you first start engaging in conversation. What does this insecurity test look like? Well, this is going to be where she purposefully positions her cell phone, or maybe she purposefully tells stories regarding other men. Okay, so here's what this may look like. If you're seeing a woman, maybe you've been intimate with her in the beginning, maybe you haven't, it's irrelevant. What the woman will oftentimes do is she'll lay out the phone purposely to show you other options. Maybe there might be online dating notifications going off. There might be Snapchats booming. There might be Snapchats buzzing. What she's doing is she's seeing if you're going to get reactionary to that. The best advice is you can not react. Okay, do not react in that situation when a woman tries to draw out any insecurity. On a subconscious level, the chick that you're seeing is going to know that a man wants to ensure, right, that the woman who he's with, the woman who he's intimate with, is his for the time being, right? The last thing a man wants to know is that there's other S3 actual options entertaining her. Because of that, this insecurity test, chances are, if she's with you in the beginning, there is not going to be a whole lot of other men that she is consistently being intimate with, but nevertheless, this is a test you need to be aware of. On the front end, the second test is going to be the options or the framing test. I call this the options framing test. Now, here's what this is. What this test is going to be is this test is going to be anywhere from the 2-week to 6-week mark. Okay, when you see a woman in the 2-week to 6-week mark, what you're going to notice is you're going to see things like stories on Instagram, maybe Snapchat stories, things of that nature, of the woman interacting with other men. Okay, now here's the kicker with this one. This could be a cousin, right? This could be a brother that you didn't know of. This could be a coworker. This could be a dude that she friend zoned. Chances are, 9 times out of 10, it is not going to be another companion that the woman is regularly engaging with on an intimate level. You have to know this and you have to understand this. What this is this is her painting a picture or a story of showing other men to potentially fuel jealousy in you. What this is actually doing, you might be sitting here going, Casey, what's the premise of this test? Why would I be tested in this format? If me and this woman have been seeing each other, if we've been intimate within the first 2 to 6 weeks, why does this test occur? Well, here's one thing that she's doing. This is sniffing for premature attachment. Okay, the attachment when it comes to a LTR, a long-term committed relationship, needs to be fueled by the chick. Okay, it needs to be fueled by the girl. She needs to desire to lock down the man. Here's what happens. The reason why she is sniffing for premature attachment on your end is because this is going to signal weakness. The second that this signals weakness, it's the second she no longer desires the relationship with you. This is all frames. So this options framing test, what she's trying to do is promote different options or different men she may be talking to, because chances are in the 2 to 6 week mark, you guys are not official. Because you're not official, she needs to see if you're whipped. This is why sniffing for premature attachment is one of the quickest ways she can start to weed out any sort of alpha behavior versus weak, you know, 99%er behavior. This is the second test you need to be aware of. Do not react. The second you react is the second you show jealousy and or insecurity. It lowers your value. A king does not get jealous to anybody. Number three, okay, this is going to be the favors test. Favors in return for zero. This is what I mean. I can back this one up with a personal story. When I was about 19 years old, okay, I'll never forget this. I was about 19 years old and there was a woman who I was seeing locally, okay? What happened was at the time I had a boat and I had a jet ski, okay? So here's what happened. The woman started messaging me first. Hey, can we go boating? Can we do this? Can I bring XYZ chick, right? Instantly, me being 19, me being young, and me being dumb, okay, I thought, oh, cool, she's into me. In actuality, she needed a favor of having a boat to go on because it was 95 degrees that summer. And in return, I got zero, okay? When it was about 6 o'clock, they packed up and left, and I didn't hear from her. So because of that, what you got to understand is that these favors you do not want to do and you want to minimize. If a woman has genuine desire for you on all levels and on all fronts, what will happen is that she will want to enter into your premise and be with you despite you doing absolutely nothing. Okay, just you as you are is going to raise the interest. The favors test you have to be aware of and you cannot fall for it. Test number four is going to be the categorization, okay? The categorization test. This is what a girl will say to you, like, aren't you the guy who XYZ? Aren't you the guy who has a lot of options? Aren't you the guy who is kind of quiet? Aren't you the guy who is into video games? Aren't you the guy who is only about business? What the chick is trying to do is categorize you as the type of guy to get you to fit in a box, okay? Women want a sense of familiarity and or security, and the last thing that they want is have to figure a guy out live and in the flesh. If she can categorize you and figure out what type of guy you are before you even get a chance, you are going to feel as if you have to fit this box, and ultimately she is going to feel like she already has you figured out. This categorization test usually starts within the very first day or the very first interaction. And this right here is one you have to watch out for, because if a woman is having a fixed preconceived notion of you, essentially you're being stripped of your masculine seduction and virtually now you're being put in a category. Watch out for the psychological framing cues. The last test, number five, is going to be the I'm not the type two test. When these words come out of a woman's mouth, oftentimes what it really means is I'm not the type to do any of these things with you. You don't raise my attraction enough, just you as you are. You're not seductive enough. Whatever the case is, maybe it's how you look, maybe it's your height, maybe it's anything. You're not that guy, okay? Some women will view you as a 6, some women may view you as a 10, but ultimately it is your job to consistently have the confidence and carry yourself as a 10. If you run into this test, know on a deep level that you're not going to be everybody's stride. You're not going to be everybody's slice of pie. And that's okay. Okay, if you're part of Headman Nation, there's a very high chance that you love the videos on this channel. But chances are, you maybe are not a fan of other channels or vice versa. That's just how life works. So, these are the 5 tests on the front end. Okay, these are the tests that will make or break if you're actually able to get that woman to view you as the type of guy she would want to be with on an intimate level. But transitioning this, here's where guys totally lose the boat. Back end game is everything that happens once a woman has entered into your frame or has admitted that she wants to be intimate with you. This can be anywhere from 2 months into a relationship all the way to 20 years if you're the type of guy who's married. And I've seen these on all fronts. These next 5 tests, not only do you have to be very aware, so that way they don't happen, but you have to be conscious enough to spot them live and in the flesh. If you can spot them live and in the flesh, you will win. The very first test that you will notice on the back end is going to be the gifts test. Okay, women oftentimes will like gifts. Have you ever wondered why shopping malls oftentimes market or promote to women? Why is it oftentimes that, you know, girls like fancy clothes and things of that nature? A girl's closet oftentimes will be full of high heels and stuff like that. Here's why. If you get hit with the gifts test, the I deserve XYZ, right? I've been a good girl, I deserve XYZ, right? When a woman is trying to get a gift out of you, she's trying to get you to invest. And most importantly, you have to understand this is an investment of your resource. Investment of your resource that you saved or that you earned. Now it is up to you if you want to give into this and do this, but what you have to remember is that a true gift comes from a type of interaction where you genuinely want to give it. Okay? If you have to be prompted to give it, you're being played. So I recommend, in order to get through this test, you have to say, yeah, we'll see. We'll see. Maybe I'll surprise you one day. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. But what this is actually happening on a deep level is a woman is trying to get you to invest in ways you probably have not. What do we know about investment? The more your investment rises, the less hers goes down, or the more hers goes down, and vice versa. The second is going to be the intimacy withdrawal test. Okay, with excuses for why it is not wanted. Now, this is what I see typically with guys who are in my RBM, Relationship Blueprint Mastery. This is going to be for the married men or guys in significantly long LTRs of 6 months plus. Okay, what you're going to see with this is, in the beginning, you guys were consistently all over each other. Okay, and then what happens in the long run is, as she has you more figured out, as you invest more, maybe you give more gifts, maybe you give more dinner dates, all of a sudden, there's every single reason why she does not want to be intimate. There's a chance that her stomach could hurt. She has not showered yet. She's insecure. She claims that she doesn't like how she looks that day. Maybe she has a headache. But the fact is, when you notice these trends over and over and over and over, there's an element or an aspect of withholding. And that element or aspect of withholding, what most times guys do is they overinvest, or they invest even more. They will give more attention. They will give more flowers. They will give more sweet gestures. And the problem is, this further facilitates the issue. The only thing that you can control as a man is where you put your time and where you put your attention and where you put your resources. If you are not being validated the way you would like, then you do not overextend or overvalidate. Instead, what you actually do is you pull back the attention. You start to remove layers of intimacy. You remove layers of care. The one power that you have that nobody has probably ever told you is that you have absolute control over your emotional standpoint. Just think about that for a second on a deep level. How many times has any man actually looked themselves in the mirror and say, you know what, I'm in control of my own emotions. My emotions don't control me. How often does a guy do that? Virtually never. So this is the difference in life. I'm going off on a tangent here. This is the difference between being reactionary in life versus being at the levers of control. Okay? The point in life where I feel most powerful, most strong, is at the point where I'm in maximum control of my own life. Okay? The only way I can do that is if I'm in control of my emotional standpoint. Okay? If a tornado rips through my house, I'm going to be at the reactionary aspect of that. But here's the thing. If I take a second, I take a deep breath, I say, you know what? I'm going to be strong. That tornado that ripped through my house, I'm going to find a way to rebuild the house. I'm going to find a way to ensure that I get adequate insurance to help pay for this. I'm going to come at this level-headed. I'm going to win. That's a totally different mindset you can consciously control. Most guys are going to go, oh my God, my whole life's turning upside down. And they're going to get on the phone with their mom and they're going to start crying. This is not what you want to do. So consistently be at the levers, right? Of, instead of being reactionary, you have to be the one exerting your will onto life, not having life exert its will onto you. Small tangent, but that goes a long ways. The third test is going to be the purpose pulling. Okay? When you are crushing it in life, the chick's fantasy is going to be to turn you into a beast that is not what he used to be. If you were a beast, maybe you were going to the gym, you're strong, maybe you were boxing, maybe you're making a lot of money, you're crushing it in life, right? A woman's job, she will purposefully try to pull you off that center to make you less. And you're going to notice the nagging starts. And this causes the most confusion to guys. And they say, well, Casey, if all of these things are so attractive to women, if women like muscles, if women like confidence, if women like big D energy, if women like a type of guy who's crushing it, who's provisioning power strong, who has financial gain and success, why on earth would she want to pull him off of those things to make him less attractive, okay? This is a competency test in and of itself. The reason why a woman wants to do this is to see if she can. And the second that she can is the second that you prove her right and she no longer values the things that you have or have made yourself into. This is why you need to be the focal point of your own life at all times. This right here is a test of your competence, and the second you let this happen is the second that everything that you've built for yourself holds no weight, right? If you look at the situation Kanye West is going through right now, I think that that's a perfect example. Number four, okay, the situational vulnerability test. The situational vulnerability test is going to be anything where the woman might say, I want you to open up more. I want you to be more emotional. I want you to tell me how you feel. And guess what happens? The second you do that, not only do you start to bore her, but she will now be in control of that psychological frame and of that interaction, and you will watch desire drop tenfold. Last but not least, this is my favorite that I want to discuss. The fifth test when it comes to back-end game is going to be long-term competence. Okay, this ties into number three. But you have to truly understand and grasp this at the deepest level. It is a woman's job to try to see if she can turn you into a little four-letter word that may or may not start with a B. If a chick can do that to you, you have to understand just how deeply you failed the long-term competence test. Because in the beginning, you were everything that she probably wanted. You were strong, you were charismatic, you had control over your life, you had control over your vision and your purpose. And slowly over time, you became a sliver of what you were. And maybe it was done psychologically to you, maybe it was done through manipulation, but what you're going to notice 9 times out of 10 is it doesn't matter because the end result is a lesser version of what you were in the first place. If you fail this, the relationship is practically over. Fellas, these are the 10 more tests of female nature you are going to want to 100% master. And if you made it this far into the presentation, I advise two things. The first thing is to not take on these challenges anymore in 2022 all by yourself, which is why I advise you, go down below and watch the MBT webinar. If you're new to MBT, this stands for Masculine Behavioral Techniques, okay? These techniques are a proprietary system I use inside my coaching and in my communities. It's a completely free training, A through Z. You're going to see the four keys to mastering MBT once and for all so you can attract and keep the woman that you have always wanted. This is a powerful training. I advise you to take notes and block out a full hour. It's a great presentation that I shot brand new for 2022, and I can't advise you to do that any harder. Number two, I advise you to go down below and subscribe to the Headman Nation newsletter. Inside of the Headman Nation newsletter, you're going to be seeing me pull back the curtain and show you proprietary frameworks and take you behind the scenes inside what I'm doing with this company. Hit the like button, guys, comment and subscribe, and we will see you in the next one.